Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Alchemy Stars on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Alchemy Stars and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Alchemy Stars. So without further ado, let's get to it.
First of all mates, to start we have to open our favorite browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's go to this URL I'm highlighting in green. Now, you can see on the PC screen. You don't need to type it, simply because there's the clickable link in the description of this video in the first pinned comment. We arrived right here on the website of Usitility, exactly where we have a nice in-depth demonstration on how you can download and install Alchemy Stars on personal computer. We browse down a little bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on this link, we arrive here on the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to this game Alchemy Stars on our PC. As you can discover from here, we access several pros of preferring using this emulator. Then, we are ready to start downloading the Alchemy Stars by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green. The step is clicking on that button. And the download action takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to run the installer, so we need to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the computer. We answered yes. I reduced the internet browser to find the installer better. The installer is uncomplicated. It contains two choices, install, and setup path. I am going to clarify what setup path genuinely does. We just simply click on it. Therefore, we observe that we end up with here the path where your emulator is going to be put in. If we desire to change for better this directory, we are required to click on this browse option. Therefore, we pick another folder and install the emulator where we want. I will set it where it is. I click on back. So I simply click install. Voila, the setup begins and it's going to move forward together with the download of these MB which are shown on this computer screen. The time you save it on your computer, it might possibly be a little more or less megabytes. The download speed could go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, depending on your connection and depending on the velocity of the emulator hosting servers. Right away they're going very fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this point, the emulator happens to be started immediately. As you will notice, down here, there's a progress bar that will advance to the right when it gets to the ending. The emulator is going to be started for the very first time. The fact is the emulator was already started, here for the first time. Before we carry on, as you can see now, it has made two software icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is definitely the only one we're concerned with. The moment we have to start Alchemy Stars on our PC, we double-click that app icon and use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. We should perform the following step, that is a requirement, and that's to entry the Google Play Store. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is started. Right here we must sign in. At present as soon as we're there, we have to begin doing the next phase that is absolutely mandatory. So that we just click on, sign in. At this point it shows, checking info. It could in some cases get blocked in, checking info, and so it doesn't continue. If that's the case, you could attempt to log in after a couple of hours but it will surely most certainly be sorted out. At this point we will insert our login name and password. The email has to be a Gmail email and its associated password. For instance you can utilize the same exact email address you're using at the moment in your YouTube account. So I am going to type in my details and I will revisit when I have done it. That's all, details typed in. And here is Google welcoming us and providing us the terms of service. We must approve them all by simply pressing, I agree. After that, it make us possible to save to the Google Cloud. You could let it checked and it'll generate a backup of your files on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you can utilize that feature if you like. We simply click on accept. Google Play Store is launched automatically and immediately. To set up the app, we have to get to the Android emulator desktop by double-clicking on that app icon indicated green-colored. Today that we are watching the desktop of this Android emulator, we observe that we come with here the install app game button. we click or double click on that button. Right here we get the game app. Let's quickly press there on the install option that I'm just displaying now in green color. Therefore, it will begin the software installation. At present it should download and install the Android game, it will take a bit of time or perhaps it might well be almost immediate. That all varies on the internet connection. It has as of now ended setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by pressing this particular button that I'm presenting in green, to be able to use Alchemy Stars for the first time. We're by then on the emulator desktop, then we're about to mouse click on this fresh Alchemy Stars app icon which was generated. This video game is started for the first time. Now there we get it, I'm able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should discuss the volume level of this emulator. It's here. We have the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume, this way we don't count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of this emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we could switch on the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. That is actually the first one, we mouse click on this particular software icon that I'm identifying in green color. Then the monitor is maximized, offering one border at the top, one at the right and the third one at the bottom. Supposing that we wish to run the video game in full screen, we click this software icon. And we might at present be experiencing the game app in full screen mode. To stop the 100% screen functionality, click the F11 key. And we'd now end up being in regular computer screen mode. At this moment I am starting to demonstrate you the computer keyboard mapping that is really extremely cool. This step we will likely be in a position to play the game app far more easily. The first thing is to click this application icon. And here you will be able to get the required configuration settings. I'm going to keep the normal configuration, though if you choose to adjust this, you can easily do this with no problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is totally in our own language. Occasionally it happens that the emulator is launched in the erroneous language, as an example, in Mandarin. Then to place it in the proper language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then there inside of additional options, we just click on the language drop down. We can also go with the language we prefer, German, Japanese, and so forth. As soon as the language is decided, we are going to save, the emulator would restart, and the game app, next time we use it, would as well be in the opted for language. At present, there's another information that we will need to take into account, and it's that we will receive an email telling that a different equipment has been associated with this Google account. It definitely will check with us if we are the ones who have connected that device. That's right, we may not worry, considering that the emulator is simulating an Android tablet or smartphone. And then to discover which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we return here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. So we go here to the model choice. And right here we notice that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for that training. I anticipate you enjoyed it, particularly that everyone found it interesting. In this case, allow it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your comments, questions or suggestions, put them in the comment area below. You can even comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams ever so often, you have it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Click on any of these online videos which are usually appearing on the listing of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the next video game videos. Bye.